testament to Lee, because he'd written a story that was so not fantastical and not, he didn't write a monster, he wrote a very, very true story.
Where are you?
Show yourself! Do it!
There you are.
Oliver, Jack, in the words of his girlfriend Cecilia, is a sociopath. How was your construction process to enter a mind of a character like this?
Someone sitting in that chair.
It was quite a long process. Lizzie and I and Lee sat down, and Lee and I started talking about 2 months before we started filming of what we wanted from Adrian as a character. And then Lizzie and I got together and started talking about what the dynamics of their relationship was. And so it was sort of getting pieces of information and building him. What was important was to create a character that was so multifaceted, and which is often the case with people like this, people that are that operate this way.
Figured out a way to be invisible.
That's ridiculous.
The Invisible Man is an iconic character. What did you think when you received the call to play the role?
What happened to him?
Do you know what? I didn't, for some reason, I hadn't put it together. I hadn't sort of realized that it was the Invisible Man. It was called The Invisible Man, but I thought it was just a title. Because the script was so so grounded in reality, and it was a very kind of human experience. It was such a kind of human script that I hadn't really put together that it was the Invisible Man of the Universal kind of monsters universe until I got to Australia, and then it got announced that I was sort of playing him. And the deluge of stuff that I got, just being like that, oh my God! And I just hadn't kind of, I don't know why, I hadn't really realized that it was, that I was playing someone so iconic until I was there. But again, it's a testament to Lee, because he'd written a story that was so not fantastical and not, he didn't write a monster, he wrote a very, very true story.
After reading the script and getting in touch with Elizabeth, what do you think of the approach to telling the story from Cecil's perspective?
I'm not crazy.
I think it's really important, and I think that's again why Lee has created a really interesting movie. Because if we look at the way historically and still to nowadays how women and men, but in our case women, are in these situations and stuck in these relationships and are asking for help, and what seems to happen historically is that we say that they're crazy, or we say that there's something wrong with them. And we don't believe them. And I think that that's what's so brilliant about what Lee's written. He's written a movie about a woman not being believed when she is in dire need of help. And she isn't a victim. She is stuck in this situation and no one's believing her. And so I think it's important to tell stories like that. So I think, you know, we don't need to tell us another story about a man. We've had so many. Like, it's important that we're telling this story from the woman's perspective and what she has suffered as a result of this relationship.
Please listen to me.
Please, my dad,
I see you!